Question number one is, do you actually want to do this yourself? Do you want to start 3D printing? Of course, that brings up the IP issues. There's trademark, trade dress, patent, copyright, trade secret potentially. And certainly we have to run through all of those issues if a client is looking to get into the 3D printing world.
Now you have almost no lead time between design and idea to actual manufacture. And that change alone can bring companies into an area that could be of some concern to them or bring them into legally dangerous areas if they don't have the protections that they used to have through the old manufacturing process.
I think if they want to protect their product, they need to look at how do I get IP protection so that I can stop a potential person from 3D printing my product. One of the key things now is how we draft patent claims. So we have to come up with a different strategy to try to capture the middleman, the person who's scanning the product. He's not making the product, that person's not building or selling, they're just doing a scan, sending that electronic blueprint to somebody else who's actually making the product. So how do we stop that person from making the scan that precipitates someone else from actually copying the product?